switch to turn 11 is off like this. So you come around here, and I just make this kind of turn. And so I'm slow and soft on the brakes, easy the whole way. If you hit them hard anywhere in this, the car gets unsettled. Another way to go down is this way, along, and then make the turn up. And this is a little bit easier because you can get your braking done in a straight line. So if your braking isn't really smooth, it's not going to upset the car as much as it would this way, because there's a lot of dynamics going on at that angle and turning and braking. And that's why the car's getting upset. And that's why they designed the turn that way. They wanted to make it tricky. So, another way is to get your braking done as it's coming down and you're a straight line. And then, off the brakes gently, and then turn up. But by then you're a little bit slow here. So, that's one way to do it. I think that the next best way, other than the way I do it, is to kind of get down here fast, straight line, and then turn up. Let's just try that one that I just described and see how it feels.
Okay.
In the rain, you come down here, and you go across, and you go through, and then you come up, around the turn.
Wow.
Yeah.
Totally different.
It's because there's a strip of sealer here, and you can't go on the sealer. So you have to go around the sealer. And actually, you cross the sealer here, but you're going in a straight line. And then you get outside the sealer, and then you come up back. And you hit the sealer comes over like this, but you hit it going this way, straight over
straight
the hill.
Over top.
Glad we didn't have to do the rain line. It's very difficult. It's crazy, you know. It's almost every place on the track where you haven't been. For instance, coming down the back straight, you go all the way to the end, and then around the top. And then going over Madness, you go to the right, all the way to the right, and around it on the outside. And then you come down the hill, and you go to the left, all the way past the sealer, and you make a turn, and then you go this way. And then you cross the sealer and go up in Madness over the right. It's just, you know, you get the idea.
Those little nuances, huh?
Yeah. It's a hunt and peck. There are a couple things you do in the rain. One is you look for shininess. And anywhere it's shiny, don't go. Because it's either standing water or sealer. So you look for that rough, matte finish track. And you also always go to the high side of the track because the water's running down.
No.
And so you go to the high part. Also, nobody drives on the high part. So it's grippier. And there's less water, and there's usually no sealer because nobody drives there.
It's grippier where no one's driven. Is it because there's no rubber up there? I thought
No, it's because nobody's their track isn't worn down.
Okay.
Because this stuff really does wear down, and it gets polished. In fact, if we're going down the back straight near the brake area, if the sun is the right angle, you can see it shining. Because the cars have buffed the track shiny.